Lately, I've been painting more in the studio. Why? Well, because as much as I love painting outdoors, I find the studio more freeing. Rather than being a slave to time and to the motion of the sun, I'm free to explore design, work out color schemes, and to take my paintings to the next level. And yes, when I work in the studio, I may in fact use photos, but I understand the limitations of photography, and so I incorporate other reference material in my process, like pencil sketches and color studies. In this video, I want to share with you the types of reference material I use. But first, why don't I rely on photos exclusively? Well, photos have three basic problems. First, they distort values. If you meter off the lights, you lose information in the darks. That is, they become so dark you can't see anything there. If you meter off the darks, you lose information in the lights. Everything is washed out. Photos also distort color. Most cameras today have an automatic white balance that adjusts for light temperature, but it's not perfect. The image still may be too warm or too cool. Also, the camera sensor doesn't have anywhere near the sensitivity to color that your eye has. Photos distort perspective, too. Phone cameras are particularly bad at this, sometimes giving an almost fisheye-like distortion to the image. The problem isn't so bad with the natural landscape, but it can be really noticeable with architecture. Finally, unless you're doing 3D photography, photos don't show depth. There's nothing like standing in front of your subject to see how things really sit in space. Although I'm a firm believer that working from life gives you all the information you need for a successful painting, it doesn't always give you enough time to reach your goal. And since it's not possible to move a mountain vista into my studio where I do have the time, I need to rely on really good reference material. And sometimes memory. I can't help you with memory, but I can help you with gathering good reference material. There are basically three different types. First, pencil sketches. Sketching is vital in that you are training your hand, eye, and brain to work together to analyze and remember value and form. What's more, you're not just exploring the relationship of objects in the two-dimensional picture plane, but also their relationship in three-dimensional space. Next, color studies. Color studies, whether done in oil, pastel, or some other medium, are important, not just for capturing local color, but also for capturing the color temperature contrasts of light and shadow. This will help you to recreate the moment accurately in the studio. And yes, photos are important too, as much as they aren't very useful for value, color, or perspective, they are great for detail. If there's any detail you missed in your pencil sketches that you feel you need for the painting, photos will be a great help. Okay, so now you're asking, how do I go about gathering reference material in the right way? First of all, your reference material needs to be project specific. It's a lot easier to have a particular project in mind, such as painting a waterfall in spring, and to go out and gather your reference material at that time, than it is to scroll through thousands of your old photos looking for what you need. It's also a lot more fun and better exercise. Also, starting with a specific project keeps you focused. Looking through thousands of photos offers too many off-ramps. You get to where you're going sooner if you stay focused. Your material needs to capture the key important elements. Here's what you need to know about how this works for each of the different types of reference material. There are several kinds of pencil drawings that will be useful to take back to studio. You can make detailed drawings of elements in the scene that you may want detailed in the final painting, or to help you understand the modeling of form. You can make value sketches to capture the relative values of adjacent shapes. Finally, you can make your first tentative explorations of design. Detailed drawings can be as complex as you want them. Value sketches should be simple and broad. Design explorations can be quick and abstract. Color studies, and whatever color medium you wish to use, can be done rapidly. You're not looking to create anything remotely like a finished painting. The temptation is there whenever I pick up a brush, but I have to remember this is just a study. Drawing is not important, nor is your handling of the brush. Basically, you just want to put down color shapes. You want to capture local color, that is, what the color of something actually is, such as a brown tree trunk, and also the relative color temperature relationships of light and shadow. In my paintings, I often like to push color and make it more saturated. But when I make a color study, I try to be as accurate as possible, even if the color looks a little dull. All that said, you can certainly use finished planar paintings for your color studies, so long as the color is true. Camera memory is cheap these days, and when I'm gathering reference material for a project, I take lots of pictures. I take a photo of anything I think I might possibly want to include in my painting. I also make sure to get photos of any details that seem important, especially if they concern my center of interest. Finally, I also include some wide-angle shots to help remind me of the moment, how warm it was, what the lighting was like, and so on. These wide shots might even give me some design ideas. Generally, I take high-resolution photos. Since I view the photos on my tablet while painting in my studio, I can easily zoom in for detail. I hope this gives you some idea of what I find valuable in reference material. Remember that you have many tools available to you, and if you use them wisely while keeping a specific project in mind, you'll have success. If you'd like more help, I can recommend my book, Outdoor Study to Studio, Take Your Planar Paintings to the Next Level, which is available at Amazon, and also my self-study course in planar painting, which is available at www.planaressentials.com. Both of these are on your screen. Whatever your approach, remember to breathe while you're painting.